carros que para su parada fueron arriba.
Acá vivo con mi mamá, mis hermanos y su compromiso.
I live here with my mom, her partner, and with my siblings. We've lived here for more than 18 years, 19 this year.
19 prácticamente, con este año de acá. Bueno, mi papá viajó a la selva.
My dad traveled to the jungle for work. He wanted to give a better future to my mom and me. But it was the time of terrorism, and one day, a family member called at my grandparents' house, saying that my uncle and father had passed away because the terrorists had killed them. We never found out what happened to the body, neither my father's nor my uncle's.
¿Es difícil para la gente de San Juan para encontrar trabajo, ganar su vida?
Bueno, yo creo que sí, ¿no? Para toda persona es difícil encontrar un buen trabajo.
I think it's difficult for anyone to find a good job. I have many friends that are without work. To get a job, you have to prepare yourself for an interview, and then depending on the interview, they accept you or not. Then there's the training you need if you get the job.
No solamente la gente de San Juan, sino la gente de todos sitios. Bien entras o bien no entras, ¿no? A trabajar en una empresa fija.
It's not only people from here in San Juan, but people from all over Lima that are either selected or rejected to work in a business. So I went to a workshop that prepared me for how to do an interview. Before I started working, I applied to many businesses, including Peruvian supermarkets like Metro, Plaza Vea, Santa Isabel, and I also went to Bembo's, a fast food chain. Everyone told me to wait for the call, that in 2 weeks from now, we will call you.
Pasaban las dos semanas y no nos llamaban.
The 2 weeks passed and they didn't call me. They told us that they would first call those with most experience in sales or in the job and then look at the rest of us. And many times, they never ever call you back. But eventually, I did get a call from Bembo's, which is where I'm currently working.
Fue de Bembo's donde estoy trabajando actualmente.
Dijiste que recibiste entrenamiento. ¿Eso lo recibiste en el Centro de Jóvenes y Empleo?
And what type of training?
¿Y cómo fue el entrenamiento? Si puedes describir un poco.
Bueno, sí lo recibí.
Yes, I received training at the Youth Employment Center from the San Juan de Miraflores municipality. The best sessions were the workshops where they taught you which words to use in an interview and how you should present yourself. They also look at our resume.
Yo fui a una charla donde que Mike también estaba presente.
I went to a workshop where Mike was also present, and we saw a video on how to look for work and which papers we needed, the curriculum we need to have, and how it should look.
I'm Mike Cameron, Custo VSO cooperant, working in Lima, Peru. My job is about helping promote a youth employment center in the San Juan de Miraflores municipality. It's a center to help improve youth's ability to find work, to start their own business, or to help orient themselves in what kind of studies they'd like to pursue. What we're developing is a center for youth employment. It's based on a model that was born in Gatineau, Quebec, called Carrefour de l'Outaouais. It's a place where youth can come, they're welcomed, and the point of the center is that they can find what they're looking for, which is usually for youth a big issue is finding work, starting their own business, or trying to find out which path to follow in terms of their career.
Well, here we are. This is the Youth Employment Center in San Juan de Miraflores. If you want to follow me through, we'll see what it's all about.
Buenos días. Buenos días.
¿Están buscando para algún servicio?
Sí.
¿Sí? ¿Buscando empleo?
Sí.
¿Es su primera vez aquí? ¿Han hecho su currículum vitae? Sí. ¿Lo tienen contigo?
Sí.
Muy bien. ¿Tú también? Acompáñanos. Sí. Adelante. Aquí, ¿tienes una ficha llena del centro de jóvenes?
No, 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 no,
Ah, perfecto. Ahí el joven que está ahí, Robert, está encargado de dar la lista de empleos. Ahí puedes revisar y hacer una selección. Puedes tomar asiento, ahí te voy a pasar el consolidado. Esa es la hoja con los diferentes trabajos de hoy. Te voy a encontrar una copia. This is another hall that we get to use, and it's made for the bigger groups. They call them mass convocations, and usually they come in groups of about 50 to 80 to 100 to come for businesses like Plaza Vea, Ripley, and these are supermarkets in Peru. Usually hire about 40 to 50% of the people who show up. We had a group of about 60 people that came in yesterday, and the lady told me that 27 were hired for Plaza Vea, Ripley, another local business called San Fernando. So we've talked about the first service, which is the main service for now, which is helping to find work. The other two main services are trying to help start a business, and the other is professional guidance for trying to find your profession, your career guidance. It's common to hear that once they've come to the center, that they're able to find work a bit easier. They get their first call back from having dropped off the interview. I think the secret and what's working well is that it gives them a moment to reflect on what strengths they have, build a bit of confidence before going to do the interview, and having that bit of an edge, because you have to understand that in San Juan there's 46,000 youth that are unemployed or sub-employed, and so there's a huge amount of competition to get into, to get a job. So if you're not on the top, you're not going to get through. So a lot of people sort of feel like they have to accept any kind of work, and so often when we see them at the center, they'll come in and they'll say, we'll ask them, what kind of work are you looking for, and they'll say, work, whatever you have. And so the process is sort of to flip it around and say, no, you have to know what you're looking for. You know, what are you looking for in work? What are your strengths? What kind of work environment are you like to work in? And from there we can see what the different possibilities are. And they go off after what they really want, not just sort of be passive receivers of the work that they eventually get.
No siento que me ayude a encontrar trabajo, no es, me ayudó a buscar trabajo.
I don't feel that it helped me find work. It helped me look for work. Before, I was looking for work through advertisements, but it didn't work out for me very well. Afterwards, with my mom, I went to the youth center, and they told me about various options for several jobs, to which I applied. But I still didn't get any calls. Then I learned how to present myself at job interviews, and that helped me a lot to find the job where I'm currently working. Well, I was working at a Bembo's restaurant in Monterico. To get there, I walked for a while, and then a combi bus took me the rest of the way to work. But now they've transferred me to a restaurant in Caminos del Inca in Surco, and it takes about 45 minutes to walk there. I have to cross over the wall that separates San Juan, where I live, from the area known as Surco.
Why do you think they put a wall between San Juan and over there?
¿Por qué crees que han puesto un muro entre San Juan y Surco?
Es una residencia, porque esta zona es gente pobre y para ellas gente plata.
It's a residential area because on this side it's poor people and on the other side it's people with more money.
The wall won't come down. It will only be raised higher. Normally, I can pass here and get down this way to work. But some time from now, this wall won't exist. They will make a larger one. Then, people will have to figure out how to get to work, because there are people that leave at 5 in the morning and have to cross the wall because they work down there in the construction close by. If they build the higher wall, people will have to take a combi bus until they get to that point over there, which is really close by foot, but by transportation is further.
Which side of the wall would you rather live on, San Juan or this side?
Sobre aquí, el lado del muro, preferirías vivir, el lado de Surco o de San Juan.
San Juan.
¿Por qué?
Porque digamos que ya me acostumbré.
Because let's say that I've become accustomed to the way I live, to what I do daily, to the people. The people from San Juan are more humble than the people from Surco. The people from Surco, well, not only Surco, but from many places, they say that we who live here, on this side of the wall, don't have values, or that we don't have respect towards anyone or anything. But it's the opposite. They are the ones who don't respect us, the ones who perhaps don't have as many values. They've demonstrated that many times.
Y lo han demostrado varias veces.